T-accounts are awesome. T-accounts are the most useful tool in accounting. T-accounts are fundamental to your understanding of accounting. T-accounts are helpful in solving any accounting problems. T-accounts are spectacular. Okay, that's enough praise for T-accounts. Let's get to work. How do you master T-accounts? By taking four simple steps. Stay with me and let's get this done. Here's a very simple definition of a T-account. A T-account is a visual representation of an account to think through the journal entries you're going to make to record transactions. T-accounting step 1. Take a piece of paper and draw a T. No, not that one. A capital T. Now write debits on the left, credits on the right. This is something you need to memorize. Repeat it to yourself 50 times per day. Put post-it notes all over your house, or even better, download the Finance Storyteller lock screen wallpaper image for your phone. So you can repeat debits on the left, credits on the right every single time you pick up your phone. T-accounting step 2. Take a look at this T-account and this balance sheet. Looks pretty similar, right? That's because it's the same basic idea. Debits on the left, credits on the right. Asset accounts in their natural state have a debit balance. Liabilities and equity accounts in their natural state have a credit balance. You can think of a T-account as a mini balance sheet for one specific account in the ledger. Assets go up if you add debits and down if you book credits. Liabilities and equity go up if you add credits and down if you book debits. Here's a little secret shortcut that very few people realize. The two types of income statement accounts, revenue and expense, are essentially just a subset of equity. Revenue accounts in their natural state have a credit balance. At the end of the accounting period, they will roll up into equity and make it grow. Expense accounts in their natural state have a debit balance. At the end of the accounting period, they will roll up into equity and make it shrink. If revenue is higher than expenses, you generate a positive net income, which adds to the equity balance. T-accounting step 3. For every journal entry that you want to visualize with T-accounts, decide first which type of account you need. Asset, liability, equity, revenue, expense, and then which specific account in that category. Let's take an example with accounts and numbers from the income statement versus balance sheet video that I encourage you to watch first by clicking on the link to work through some T-account examples. Let's buy a small building and a forklift truck for $100,000 in total for our chocolate shop and pay immediately. If you read that sentence carefully, you see a specific type of assets, things that the company owns, going up in the first part, and another type of assets going down in the second part. So the type of account is assets on both the debit and the credit side. More specifically, fixed assets go up, we need to add debits to this account. Cash is going down, we need to add credits to this account. Let's buy a huge amount of product, $100,000 worth of it, that we plan to sell to customers later on, and arrange with the supplier to pay his invoice in 30 days. First part, an asset, more specifically inventory, going up. Second part, a liability, more specifically accounts payable going up. Debit inventory, credit accounts payable. The bank notifies us that the interest on the loan is due and we pay it immediately. Debit interest expense, credit cash. If you credit an asset account like cash, the balance goes down. T-accounting step 4. Let's see what the T-account for cash looks like at the end of the period. We started with $200,000 opening balance after the company attracted funding. Then credited cash when buying fixed assets by $100,000 and credited cash when paying the interest to the bank by $10,000. So the ending balance for cash is $90,000 debit balance, 200 minus 100 minus 10. Do this for each of your T accounts and you can then proceed to make a trial balance, a listing of all general ledger accounts along with their respective debit or credit balances for the period. T-accounting in 4 steps. Debits on the left, credits on the right. A T-account is like a mini balance sheet for one specific account in the ledger. For every journal entry, decide first which type of account you need and then which specific account in that category. To calculate the ending balance for an account, add up the opening balance and the debits and credits for the period. Want to learn more about accounting, finance and business? Then subscribe to the Finance Storyteller YouTube channel. Thank you!